We were given an assignment to make a timer or a clock or a alarm. Imagining that we were in 10th century, our task was to make the clock work without an energy source or power.
We choose to design the clock, which works mainly based on the turbine. You can see the rotating of the clock.
This turbine rotates through the amount of water flowing through this turbine. We'll restrict the water flowing through that turbine so that the clock doesn't go fast or slow. The main concept here is taking the water flow and making it into the energy source which runs the clock.
Project to design a product. It's a clock which works in the 10th century, and this is the product we've come up with, and Manu is going to explain the mechanism.
Yeah, so the basic principle of our clock was we regulated atmospheric pressure, that pressures on the water which moves the vertical gear upwards, which in turn moves the circular gear in such a way that it shows the time. So this is the working of our model. So we've regulated the pressure of the water in the mouth of this bottle, and the atmospheric pressure pushes it down, pushing the vertical gear on top, and hence the circular gear which shows the time. The quantity of water of this bottle gives us about 20 seconds of time. The bigger the container at the bottom, the more time you will get. So on a bigger scale, it would work.
Our second assignment was to make a product mimicking any insect, and we chose a spider. The feature we chose was when a prey sits on the spider's web, they get alerted immediately.
So the basic idea of our product was that we designed a library, automated library, where the customer can just take the book without a librarian actually being there. This is the plan of our library, which is a centralized plan with a central node and circular shelves around it. So the basic feature of how this works is when a customer picks up the book, a flap with a spring is put up, and a ball which is magnetized loses its magnetic property and flows down to the centralized node with glass tubes. And it gets registered with a barcode, and it gets stored inside the central node. And when the customer comes back to keep the book, the flap goes down again, turning on the magnetic property of the shelf itself, and the ball returns to its shelf through an underground passage.
Our next assignment was to redesign an existing product, and we chose to redesign a postbox.
The fact we found in the original post box was that it was not very ergonomics for human use. You had to put your hand in, and it wasn't very comfortable. So what we thought, we redesigned the post box in such a way that there was a channel, a flap, which could channel the letters directly inside the post box without you having to put any effort, you know, in doing that. And also it protected from rain and dust and everything else. And it also had a flat top, you could use it to, you know, write your letters or, you know, stick your stamps. And the inside working is,
So when you put your letter in, there's a channel here that takes the letter all the way down, so you don't have to physically put your hand in and push the letter down.
Yeah, that's basically it.
Our task was to design an alarm or clock in the 10th century.
So our basic initial idea was to combine an alarm and a clock, using a basic material, sand and water.
The materials used for this model is, we have used wooden frame for the base, and glass beakers, and a beam balance, and tree box for the support for the alarm thing, and a metal plate is used.
The working of the design begins by putting sand or water in the top beaker, which drops by drop falls into this bottom beaker, because of which the weight goes down and the locking system opens, the ball rolls and hits the rod, which in turn hits the plate and creates a sound.
Our task was to take a defective product and make it useful for that. We took as a paper container as a product.
And paper container, as we know, market available sizes, maximum A1. And the defect what we found was empty container consumes a lot of space, as well as it doesn't fit A0 size. So the solution what we found was we use the antenna and outer periphery so that it can be adjustable to any length. And outer surface we covered with a resin cloth, so it's waterproof as well. And this is the maximum length what we designed, that is 845 mm,
and it can be stretched for A0 size.
Yeah, and this is the minimum length which can be diminished to any of the size.
The mechanism is explained in this. As it is stretched, the length will be increased. As these are the antennas used in outer periphery, it can be increased and then it can be decreased as we push it much more down.
Okay, so we had to design a clock during the 10th century without using modern equipments or electricity, and we chose water as a medium to measure time.
So this is where the water is stored, and the water from here goes into this container where we have placed a lighter material, rises, and there are it acts as an indicator, and there are gradients in here which shows us what time it has.
Basically, we have designed a 10th century clock. So in ancient time, there were like different mediums to measure time, to calculate time. There were like a few mediums, like they used sand as a medium to calculate time. Then they used sun direction, maybe shadow, shade. And then we have came with an idea which worked in all situations. So we designed a clock in such a way that we use water as a medium. So we'll talk about our design.
We've named our idea as the time drops, where we've used water as the basic medium to calculate time. So let's move on to the mechanism of how it works.
So in the mechanism, if you see, so basically this looks like a conical shape which has an opening over there in the below side, bottom side, which can be used as an outlet, and the top part will be in an inlet for water. So different diameter sizes which varies. So according to that, we measure that whether how much we are taking it as for the minutes one or we are taking for the hour one. For the minutes one, the diameter will be little bit thicker and broader, and for the hours one, it will be very minute, and the diameter will be very less. So we'll talk about how it works.
So we have a container here, which actually is the main medium which calculates the time after the water drops from the funnel to the container. So here we have various measured time which is already pre-measured, and then as the water drops drop by drop, that's why it's called time drop, and then after it drops we can actually calculate time by using these marked measurements. So the first measurement is like 10 minutes, so we can keep changing the tumbler, and then it can be used to calculate time in hours as well as in minutes.
So basically we can see this storage tank, we can change the storage tank which has different kind of measurements. So for this we have taken the minutes one, we can take even the hours one, which will have more diameter, and this can be even used as a timer. So we can use it as a stopwatch for that time. So
we got an interesting subject, broader design as a semester. The final product was here, we had to find the product which is facing problems, and we had to redesign it. So we thought to architectural products. Normally the modeling, the most important thing is cutter. So normal cutter, we can't cut the curved things and detail. So we redesigned the cutter as a multi-purpose cutter.
So we had decided to redesign the cutter. It's a cutter which has an eraser, a blade, a needle blade, and a compass. And we had added a scale, normal scale, for the measurements.
So there are two plates over here, one plate. There's a container which drops soil onto this plate. In 1 minute, only 10 grams of the soil falls onto the plate. So in 1 hour, 600 grams falls on the plate.
So the reading shows as 600 grams in 1 hour. So basically 600 grams gets converted to 1 hour and 1200 grams gets converted to 2 hours. So when the pointer is on 1200 grams, it's 2 o'clock, and when the pointer is on 600, it's 1 o'clock. So that's how it works.
Depends on weight, the thing.
So depends on the weight falling over here, the pointer moves.
You can see the time over there.
And that's how the time gets converted.
The product that we designed is an art timer. Earlier, keys were too much in use. Like for example, car toys and clocks, wall clocks, etc.
So in our project, we have a cycle wheel, which are only the rim part of one rim part is taken and attach it to a stand, basic stand with a bell attached on the top. So when the key is given to the wheel, to the rim, the 60 spokes which we are given, which ought to get tightened, will get tightened up slowly. Will get tightened up slowly, and when the key is released, it gets unwind. When it's getting unwind, with the help of a stopper which we place in the stand, we'll get unwind for every minute, for each and every minute when it's stuck to the stopper. By 60 times of the wheel rotation, we'll get to know the 1 hour is completed. And through that, we'll be attaching a small stopper to the rim, which is hitting the bell on the stand. So when it hits the bell, one person who is working in their house or something will get to know that each 1 hour has been completed. And after this process, they again give the key to the rim, and the process continues. This is the process which we had made for our model.
Assignment of designing a device which indicates the time without using any power or electricity. So we have used in our project as a water. So our project is called as a water clock.
So the parts of our project has two containers and a drip controller. So we pour water in the first container, and we regulate the water through this drip controller. So it depends on what unit of time we want to measure. It could be in seconds, or we could measure it in hours. So depending on that, the water pours into this container. So in this container, we have a thermocol. So we know densities of thermocol and water do not match. So as water pours in, the thermocol rises, and hence there's a gear system behind. So the gear system is attached to the hand of the clock, which moves accordingly as the water gets filled in the container.
Number of keys at the same time, and then it took very less space, and then it was organized and it was pocket carrier. So we redesigned the product, and hence we named it as Sukhi, which means a Surakshita key in Kannada. So we designed the water wheel using the sheet and the spoons. So basically, when the water falls, due to the water force, it starts turning. And then this is connected to the gear system, which works like this. And then due to this, the gear is being connected to a clock. So when the water moves, the gear system automatically moves and the clock starts working.